وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، إن شاء الله تعالى. In today's episode, I want to speak about staying away from and avoiding سُوءُ الظَّنِّ بِالْمُسْلِمِينَ. Stay away from thinking bad about your Muslim brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters, one of the greatest things that Islam has done is that it's united people of different backgrounds, different ethnic background. You see a person from Pakistan and another person from Europe, another person from the Middle East, another person from China. And they all have the same belief. They are all Muslims. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He brought them together under that name, Al-Islam, became brothers. Even though they live in different places and they are from different parts of the world, something connected them, which is Al-Ukhuwatu Al-Imaniyah Wal-Rabitatu Al-Diniyah, the religion. It brought them together, it's united them. And it is from the greatest rawabit, wa awthaqu as-silat. This is something very important, brothers and sisters. The alaqah al-diniyah, al-ukhuwah al-imaniyah, is stronger. That bond that comes by way of religion is stronger and greater than any type of connection that can occur between two people. Naam. Your own brother from the same dad and the same mum as you cannot be of the same level as your Muslim brother. If your brother doesn't share the same faith as you and is of a different faith and he's not a Muslim, the Muslim brother is closer to you. And ولذلك Ibn Taymiyyah said something very powerful, rahimahullah. He said in his kitab Minhaj al-Sunnah al-Nabawiyyah, the 7th volume, page 55, he says, القرابة الديني القرابة الدينية أعظم من القرابة الطينية والقرب بين القلوب والأرواح أعظم من القرب بين الأبدان. Ibn Taymiyyah, he says, the relationship, okay, of religion is far greater than the relationship by your ethnic background. Pay attention. And you and your brother come from same mother. What is stronger is the bond of religion. Why? He mentions it here. He says, وَالْقُرْبُ بَيْنَ الْقُرُوبِ وَالْأَرْوَاحِ. Because the hearts and the souls of people becoming connected is greater than what? Than their bodies being connected. صح? This person, you might share the same DNA, you might say you might share the same biological genetics and etc. But because you differ on al-qulub, your hearts are not the same. Wal arwah, your souls are different. You hold different ideologies and different beliefs. The distance is greater. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us, Islam, and we're Muslims. That being said, brothers and sisters, if this person is your brother, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً, he's your brother, don't have bad assumptions. Stay away from having bad assumptions regarding your Muslim brothers. And that's why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He mentioned the brotherhood, and then He mentioned the concept of speculation and bad thoughts about your brothers. Look what Allah said. Allah said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً. Allah said, verily the believers are what? They are brothers. They are nothing but brothers to one another. Right. That's the same surah. If you carry on reading, Allah talks about things that can harm that brotherhood. Allah mentions it. يعني, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكن خيرا منهن ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان ومن لم يتب فأولئك هم الظالمون. Allah mentions things that can harm that brotherhood. For example, don't mock one another and belittle one another. Allah talks about don't call each other names. ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب. Don't call yourselves names. Somebody doesn't like this name, he's telling you stop it, don't call me this name, I don't like it, and you carry on calling them this name. He tells you, I don't like you calling me this, and you carry on calling them the name. Stay away from that, Allah says. وَلَا تَنَابَزُوا بِالْأَلْقَابِ. This is يعني things that harm the ayah that was mentioned before that, which is إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Because when people belittle one another, and when people ridicule one another, and when people insult one another, and when people give each other names that they don't like, it harms innamal mu'minuna ikhwa. And then after that, what does Allah mention? He says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ijtanibu kathiran min adh-dhanni. Inna ba'da adh-dhanni ithmun. Allah says, stay, oh those of you who believe, who share brotherhood by way of religion and faith and iman, do stay away from what? Stay away from speculation and assumption. Ha, innaka اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن. Stay away from a lot of assumptions. إن بعد الظن إثم. This shows us, brothers and sisters, these are things that will harm our brotherhood. They will harm it, and it will cause it problems. And what I want to focus here is الظن السيء. أما سوء الظن. Having تهمة, suspicion in your heart, with no evidence, بلا دليل, no evidence, no proof, nothing, but just mere speculations. This, I think this, I think that, oh, and I also think that, and I also think that. Stay away from that. A believer stays away from all of that. Do you have proof for it? Yes. Go ahead, then base it on proofs. But I think, I assume, he said that to me that day, huh? And he also said that to me that day. Huh? A lot of us do that. We have that characteristics. It harms our relationship. ولذلك عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه, he mentioned something very powerful. He said, لا تظنن بكلمة خرجت من مسلم شرا وأنت تجد لها في الخير محملا. عمر رضي الله عنه, ابن كثير رحمه الله mentions this in his tafsir. عمر رضي الله عنه, he says, لا تظنن, do not think to yourself, بكلمة خرجت من فم أخيك, that came out of the mouth of your brother, أما من مسلم, a statement that came out of your brother's mouth or your sister's mouth, don't think to yourself, hey, شرا, don't think to yourself that it's evil. Don't think to yourself a statement that came out of your brother's mouth or your sister's mouth, evil. هي وأنت تجد لها خيرا محملا, أما وأنت تجد لها في الخير محملا, as long if they're, sorry, don't think evil of someone's statement whilst there is a possibility of you interpreting in another good way. If there's a possibility of interpreting statement in a good way, don't think bad of that person. Or don't think bad of that statement. What Umar here is saying is that whatever comes out of your brother's sister's mouth, try your best to push it to the best of assumptions. Maybe he's tired. Maybe it came out wrong. He didn't intend that. Maybe. As long as you can find an interpretation for what he's saying, a good interpretation, take it to that interpretation. وَأَنْتَ تَجِدُ لَهَا فِي الْخَيْرِ مَحْمَلًا. And by the way, brothers and sisters, the person who benefits from doing that, number one, is you yourself. For many reasons, you benefit from taking people's kalam to the best of paths. You benefit from it. What do you benefit from it? Number one, that person doesn't stay and linger in your mind. A lot of people are stressed. Yeah, I know what he meant. And this is what he meant. And how hakada. And all of it, if you say, what did he say that to you? And you know he meant that. It's all speculations. And you're thinking over it. And then, so much. Brothers and sisters, how many relationships got destroyed based on just speculations? Both parties are thinking the worst of the other person. I've actually met two people who And he went their separate ways in terms of marriage. They're no longer married. And I, you know, out of curiosity, I just wanted to know what was the reason why they broke up, you know, to help them and to bring them together. And I realized, subhanAllah, it was lack of communication. Both parties were taking each person's actions and movements and gestures in the worst interpretation. Are we all together, brothers and sisters? Like, this is something very common amongst many of us. We have that in us. Like, for example, someone will enter the room and he will say, Assalamu alaikum. And then someone will say, I know why he didn't want to shake our hands. Because he thinks he's better than me. I think he's better. He thinks he's better than me. That's why he didn't stick his hand out and give me salams. He's got kibir in him, arrogance. He's full of himself. Why are you thinking that way? Why don't you say maybe he did that because the people were too much? And he didn't feel, yani, it was appropriate for him to go through every single person to shake their hands. And that's why he gave salam from the top. Or maybe he felt that there was a good conversation going on, and if he came, he might interrupt it. Why is there all those possibilities? You eliminated it and you took the worst of those interpretation. So remember this all the time. لا تظنن بكلمة خرجت من مسلم شرا وأنت تجد لها في الخير محملا. Rather, subhanAllah, what you tend to find is some people, they're sick. This is a marad, by the way. It's a sickness of the heart. You say to them, I never meant that. Sidqan, I never meant that. No, you did. You meant it. It's gone to that. It's gone to that level now. It's become worse. It's not just su'ul dhan. It's taqawul. You're lying about me. I'm telling you, I'm alive. Ana hayyun yurzaq. I'm alive. I'm in this world. I'm breathing. I'm telling you, I never meant that. You say, no, you did. So you know my heart better than I do. You know my motives and my intentions better than I do. Gharib, right? We're living in that time now. The people have gone worse than just su'ul dhan, speculation and assumption. They've gone as far as rejecting a person's udhur and their excuses. They don't accept it. What are they going to say to Allah yawm al-qiyamah when they get questioned and interrogated? Abi Qilaba, he said something very powerful. He's a student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. He said, إِذَا بَلَغَكَ عَنْ أَخِيكَ شَيْءٍ. If it reaches you something from your brother, تَكْرَهُ, which you dislike, فَلْتَمِسْ لَهُ الْعُذْرِ. Look for excuses for him. As much as you can. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَجِدْ. If you looked for excuses, but you still can't find an excuse for him. فَقُلْ, say, فِي نَفْسِكَ, say to yourself, لَعَلَّ لِأَخِي عُذْرًا. My brother probably has an excuse. لَا أَعْلَمْ, which I don't know. Maybe he has an excuse, I don't know it. You tried all your excuses. So this goes even further than the statement of Umar that I mentioned. Umar was what? As long as you can find an interpretation, a good interpretation, try your best to take it to that interpretation. Lakin Abi Qilaba is saying, if you can't find any udhur for them, you can't find any interpretation or excuse, just say there is, but I don't know it. And it's a rare commodity today. It's rare to find someone who has that quality. May Allah all give us all that quality, where we can see our Muslim brothers and sisters in good light, in a good way. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentioned something very powerful. Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his kitab Adab al-Mufrad. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, مَا يَزَالُ الْمَسْرُوقُ مِنْهُ يَتَظَنَّى حَتَّى يَصِيرَ أَعْظَمَ مِنَ السَّارِقِ. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, a person, ما يزال المسروق, that the person who is stolen from, he will remain entering into what? يتظنى. يعني يتظنى here, it means يدخل في الظنون والأوهام. يعني a person, something is stolen from him. A person, someone robbed something from him. And then he starts to assume, Fulan may have done it. So and so may have done it. Wallahi, I think he did it. When he came to me, he wasn't smiling. He probably, يعني ما يزال المسروق منه يتظنى حتى يصير أعظم من السارق, until he becomes worse than the one who stole. يعني he is sitting there thinking, it's Fulan, huh? I know it's him. No, I can't be him. But it's Fulan. No, not him as well. You don't just realize, You've done su'dhan of two people, which is a sin already. You're already on two. Now you're going to carry on even more. The sin that you accumulate, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is saying, it could probably be worse than the person who stole from you. Na'am. Yani, this is something we need to deeply think of. And many people don't realize this, brothers and sisters, that you can turn from being the oppressed to becoming the oppressor. It happens a lot. Sometimes people retaliate when things are done to them. They were oppressed. Initially, you were oppressed. Okay. But the person comes and retaliates and fights back. But guess what he does? He becomes the oppressor now. And he's oppressing the other person. It's very important. Always have to remember, brothers and sisters, where you need to draw the line. Where you need to draw the line. Okay? So here someone took something from you, someone stole, but your mind is going around, fulan, fulan, fulan. You go over 40 people and you say, I don't know. And then finally you say, I don't know who it is. But you've just thought bad of 40 different people. 40 different people you suspected. You did tuhma and ghiba and waqi'a and namima regarding them. And I think it's that person. But this as well. This is a sign. All that is your suspicion and your speculations. Do you have any concrete evidence? No, you don't. Get away from it. Yawm al-Qiyamah, that person will take their right from you that you've wronged. Bakr ibn Abdullah al-Muzani said something, and I'm going to conclude with his statement, and it's something very powerful. He said, إِيَّاكَ مِنَ الْكَلَامِ مَا إِنْ أَصَبْتَ فِيهِ لَمْ تُؤْجَرْ وَإِنْ أَخْطَأْتَ فِيهِ أَثِمْتَ وَهُوَ سُوءُ ظَنِّكَ بِأَخِيكَ الْمُسْلِمِ. He said something very powerful. He said, stay away from a speech that if you get it right, you're not going to get reward for it. But if you get it wrong, you get sinned for it. You get punished for it. And that is thinking bad about your Muslim brother. If this statement, you said something about someone, you got it right, you don't get no reward for it. It's no reward for you, for the statement you just said. But if you get it wrong, you're going to be punished for it. It's a sin. So if you got it right, you don't get rewarded for it. So why say it? And if you get it wrong, you get punished for it. And that is thinking bad about your Muslim brother. So it's best to leave it and avoid it, having bad assumptions of someone or a Muslim person. A Muslim should stay away from it and avoid that. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to stop there. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan. And Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.